Oh, yes, big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish.
Yeah, got it.
And it's out there. It's out there somewhere. At the back of the boat. Come on, just eat my fly, eat my fly, eat my fly, eat my fly.
The South Pacific Ocean is full of exciting angling opportunities. There's countless varieties of sport fish spread throughout the thousands of remote atolls and islands. And few are more remote than Aitutaki, and there's certainly none more beautiful. The beauty of the Aitutaki Lagoon and the bonefish and trevally that live in it has earned this place an international reputation, particularly for intrepid fly fishermen. But first off, we're loading up the boat to see what lies beyond the reef in the deep blue of the Pacific Ocean.
Special delivery, mate.
Look at these little honeys, delivered fresh to the boat, our baits.
Well, right here is the world-famous stunning lagoon of Aitutaki. And to me, it is a place that I've wanted to fish my entire life. So given that we've only got a few days here, I want to make the most of my fishing opportunities. And that's why I've recruited this woman, Jo Holly. You see, professional TV presenter, so she can come along and do the presenting, which allows me to do more fishing. And if you don't mind, Jo, if you could start by interviewing the skipper, find out what we're going to catch, where we're going to go, and how we're going to catch them.
Right,
and I can rig up some gear.
Okay, awesome. All right, sounds good. Come
right,
with me, guys.
I'm into some gear.
Hey, Jace, how's it going?
Good, thanks.
Joyce, so it's my first time here in Aitutaki. What sort of fish are we going to get?
Yep, hopefully we're going to head to one of the fads and try a little bit of live baiting first. Hopefully get some mahi-mahi or yellowfin tuna.
Beauty.
You never know, eh?
Never know. All right, well, I'm pretty keen to get out there, so let's crank it up.
Okay, right, if you just want to pass us that lure.
Man, what's the deal with this one?
Okay, that there is like a hybrid lure. It's like part soft plastic, part marlin lure, part popper, if you like. And I've just re-rigged that on a bit of fluorocarbon. And just looking at that fella, it looks like a little flying fish.
Oh, yeah.
And on the way out here, I saw a few little flying fish. Well, everything wants to eat a flying fish, so if ever you want to come back for your second life, don't come back as a flying fish. It might seem pretty cool to swim and fly, but everything wants to eat you. You want to speed us up a little bit, Jace? Probably about 4 knots. You want to hang on to that, and I'm going to get rigged up, ready for a live bait, yeah.
We're out there fishing around the fad, perfect place to pick up some mahi-mahi. So hopefully one jumps on my line.
This is great. See? I can be rigging gear, don't worry about presenting.
Oh, the anticipation again, it always gets me. Get on my line.
They're right behind us, 10 metres back.
Sorry. Oh, I'm on.
Oh, you're on? You got a bite?
Yeah.
Yeah, we just had a shot. Oh, yeah, yeah, it's right there. It's right there on it. Something on it. Keep your rod tip up. Oh, I got it on! Got it on. Keep your rod tip up. Yeah, it worked for a mahi. Now, what were we saying? We'll troll a little flying fish lure for a mahi-mahi.
Can I get the gimbal? Give me the gimbal.
Yeah, what, you've been presented for, what, 5 minutes and already you're throwing orders around? Come on. Oh, look at that mahi jumping out there. Oh, look at it go.
Mahi mahi on the line.
Okay, I'll just grab a hold of that leader if you just want to come off the gaff. What have we got? Step backwards, Joe. Now, just get some shots.
Woo!
Oh, yeah, released. Beautiful, nice release, Joe, yeah. Woo! Yeah, we kind of sacrificed that fish to get some footage.
Why not?
That's what TV's all about.
That was cool.
That was way cool. As you can see, we're fishing at a FAD, fish aggregation device, which means all sorts of fish when you're here in the tropics. It means the mahi-mahi, yellowfin tuna, could possibly be marlin, sailfish, all sorts of things are attracted to this structure out here in the deep blue water. Which so it may come as a little bit of a surprise that we're using that for a hook. We're using light tackle and we're using small baits. That is the reason for the small hook, not because the fish is small.
What's the whole deal with the FAD system?
The whole FAD system, and basically what we've got is we've got a big wide blue open ocean here, so there's not a lot of structure, and structure is like an oasis in a desert if you like. So while to the layman they just look like a group of floats, to a fish it's somewhere to hide. Little tiny bait fish, they'll hide, they'll attract the tunas will attract the marlin, the mahi-mahi, all sorts of stuff.
They're so swarming around each other.
It kicks off the food chain.
We're gonna get right in amongst it all.
Ow! We'll go right at the top of the food chain.
Have we got any fads back home in New Zealand?
We had stonewashed jeans in the early 90s. Other than that, no, not really. Yeah. Right, Joe, it's all go. What we've got here, we've got some live chum going into the water. Ali's just chucking in some of the little bait fish that were caught in the cast net this morning. Okay, well, there you go. We've got some mahi-mahi following the boat. Okay, this is really going to test my knot tying.
Oh, wow, look at them. Oh, look at it.
Yeah, look at them smashing those live baits. Ali's busy chucking some baits over the side while I'm busily trying to tie on a light fluorocarbon leader. Look at the mahis. Oh, man, this is awesome. Joe, get ready.
Right. Oh my gosh, gee, look at them, so bright.
Okay, now, that was probably as hurried a knot as I've ever tied. I'm just tying a light 30 pound fluorocarbon leader on. Ali's about to throw a bait on. Look at mahi right next to you, right here.
Wow.
Chasing those baits. Oh, look, right here at the back of the boat. Look at this. Our bait fish are swimming right back. Okay, chuck them in. Okay, right here. Okay, chuck the bait in when you're ready.
Okay,
there's our bait. There's our bait. Look, there's our fish swimming around our bait. And there he's just eating our bait. And there we have just hooked up. Come here, Joe. Come here, Joe. That's how it's done. Oh, mate. Lift your rod tip up, lift your rod tip up. Well, there you go. That's that was mean.
Oh, you beauty. Get in the boat.
Okay, gimbal belt. The guys are all lining up to put the gimbal belt on you. I stepped in and stood up and did the job myself. Now, just keep everything nice and tight.
Did they just give up?
No, you, it's got plenty of fight left in it.
Yeah. Give up, you reckon?
Give up, you reckon?
He was right there and he's just raises off and I'm like, he's given up. Not even.
Isn't it? How good is it when you can hook an awesome fish like that and get to see it for the entire fight just about?
It's so cool.
It's a nice mahi-mahi too, it's no flea. Oh, look at that reel go.
Oh.
Hear that braid.
Matt, I don't know if you've heard about this one. It might be a made-up Joe Holly story. If you're going to fillet a mahi-mahi, apparently you just slice around the outside of it all, get the tail end of it, get a couple of pliers, roll the pliers back around a couple of times, and then rip it.
You know, traditionally, it's not good karma to talk about how you're going to fillet a fish before it's in the boat. So I tell you what, I mean, you're a television professional after all, but how we prefer to do it is actually catch the fish, and then we can talk about filleting it as we're doing it. So we'll just stick with phase one for now, but that's a great insight.
Right, let's go, mahi-mahi!
Okay, just keep everything nice and smooth. Wind when you drop, and wind as fast as you can when you drop. Yeah, now lifts nice and smooth. Now you've got it down. Okay, now what you've got to remember too, another thing, when this fish gets in the boat, and I'm sure we are going to get it in, they go NATO, so stay out of its road. They've knocked people's teeth out.
Really?
Yeah, the old mahi goes NATO.
This ain't no snapper.
I know. Oh, it's getting close, Nice and smooth now. We've done all the hard work.
Man, I'm over him, I want him in here.
Oh, it's not done with yet.
Oh, you little sh.
So you having fun yet, Joe?
Oh my god, I'm gonna fillet this fish.
Okay, this could be our shot. Nice, keep it nice and smooth. Don't blow it right at the end. This is awesome, man. This is so awesome. Ahoy!
Yes!
Oh man, well done,
oh,
Joe.
Oh my god.
Now check out the colours on that thing. Just stay back until he gets the welcome aboard bat.
Yeah, can I give him one too?
Just...
yeah. Just make sure I...
Yeah. Mate, what an amazing fish. And that is exactly why we make these journeys and come to places like this. That is a stunning fish.
Quick, go! Get the shot! And hold it close to the camera, it's bigger.
Big fish out here, look at him. Big G, mate. He's coming straight towards us. Go now. Oh, you got him!
Yes! Get it in here!
Uh-oh. Listen to that line go. We're having to chase this fish. We're having to chase this fish now because I'm getting low on line.
Yes!
Oh, man.
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv. We're fishing in the deep blue water beyond the reef of the world-famous Aitutaki Lagoon. And my co-host Jo Holland is having her first mahi-mahi experience.
Oh my gosh, gee, look at them. So bright. Look at them jump.
These are amazing fish. The colours are out of this world, they are great to eat, and best of all, they're incredible sport fish, especially when caught on light tackle.
Possibly the smallest live bait I've ever used, lollipop. So we've got some chum going in the water, and my bait is just one of many that are out there. And those little baits are actually swimming back to the boat now because they've just seen the mahis, yeah. There they are, they're right, there's one right on my bait, he's just eaten my bait. Yeah, we got him, he's gonna jump, he's gonna jump right here. Woo-hoo! Look at that reel go.
Oh my God.
There he goes, jumping way out there. He got from the boat to about 50 metres away in, what, seconds. I tell you what, Joe, look, you're the presenter. You catch that and I keep rigging gear, because the more gear I rig, the more fish we're going to catch.
Oh, this is
epic. Yeah, oh boy. It's mahi time.
It's so neat in the water.
I tell you what, I might rig up my fly rod. Yeah. Joe's going to have this one in shortly. Okay, just keep working that up, Joe. Ali's going to get a hold of this one, and we want this one in the boat because, while this is a whole lot of fun for us, it's food for the island, and it's income for these guys who sell the fish to the restaurants. So not only have we got you working as a TV presenter, we've got you working as a commercial fisher.
I reckon. Putting some kai on the table.
Yeah, and I'm just going to stay right over the road, get the skier ready, this fly fishing gear. We've got a bull or a hen there. Joe, tell us about the fish. Don't muscle it too much here. Don't muscle it. Finesse it. Use just some of your woman finesse. You're going to have to walk backwards and keep that rod at a flat angle. That's the way. And Ali's got it now. Beautiful. Yow! Yeah. Look at that. How can you get tired of seeing those beautiful things?
Far out, man. Bit of a mission though to reel in.
Now I'm just stripping my fly, and as I'm doing that, Ali's throwing out some live bait, some live chum, and my fly, well I reckon, looks just like those baits, and hopefully a mahi-mahi will make that crucial mistake and eat my fly, because catching one of those, it's just going to be all time. Here they come, eh?
They're coming.
Okay, mahi-mahis are coming up on the chum. Now I've just got to see if I can get one to eat my fly. Look at the mahis!
Fly fishing has its origins in freshwater, where the fish are small and certainly not as powerful as these ocean-going pelagic fish. So if I hook up, it's going to be a real battle to land one of these fish on this fly fishing gear.
Oh, look, there's little yellowfins. They're a little yellowfin, yeah? Oh, wicked, now we've got little yellowfin tuna. Come on!
First off, just like in freshwater, we need to select a fly that looks like the food of our target species.
There's my fly. I reckon that fly looks just like those baits.
But I've still got to get the fly in front of the fish that I'm trying to catch.
Got to cast into that wind, so I've got a back cast.
And then I've got to work the fly to mimic a bait fish. And if I can get all of these things together, I might get a bite. Trouble is, I'm certainly no expert at fly fishing, but I do love a challenge.
Oh, there's one right on my fly. Oh, he had a go at it and he missed it. Did you see that? Oh, he was right on it. I'm gonna have another cast. I did out. There's tunas. Tunas all over. Oh, look at that.
Boom,
look at this yellowfin tuna at the back of the boat. Come on, eat my fly, eat my fly, eat my fly, eat my fly, eat my fly. He was right on it, man. That is awesome. Live chumming, man. For yellowfin, this is awesome. That was awesome. Oh, you got him! Yes! Yee-hoo! On the fly! Uh-oh. Oh, I lost him!
Oh,
no! Oh, well. Oh, look! Oh, there's a wahoo on the fly. Wahoo come right up on the fly. Wahoo. Holy smokes, this is all going on. We'll get some of those livers in. There's obviously that live chum, those tuna smashing at the back of the boat. Joe throwing live baits into the back of Blair's head. It's all, look, yellowfin right here. Yellowfin right.
No, I'm just throwing
right here at the back. Oh, that'll do, Joe, that'll do. There's one on my fly now. Oh, look at those yellowfins. Oh, this is awesome.
It's all go here.
Oh, look, there's one right there. There's one right there. Mahi, was it? Oh, yeah. No, it's a wahoo. Yeah, there's a wahoo there at the back of the boat. Look at that wahoo chasing that. It's only a small wahoo. Oh, look at these little baits leaping out of the water. They're packing their undies. And so they should. Oh, look, they're right there. Awesome fun, but I want to catch one. Oh, wahoo, right on it. He's eating it. Oh, and I wasn't ready. It seems to be when that fly first hits the water, he might have just snipped the whole fly off. When that fly first hits the water, that wahoo comes up on it, eh? When it first lands. Okay. Here they come, Blair. Here they come.
Oh, he got him.
Yo!
See what it was?
No, I didn't see what it was. Go not too fast, bro, because I can't wind very fast. Yeah, I'm getting a line back, so just... Yeah, this is good, bro. This is good. This is better than good. Yeah.
Good, oh, look at this.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Yes.
Oh man. Yeah.
On a fly rod.
Uh-oh. Yeah, we're gonna might have to go after this, bro. Yep.
See what it was?
No, I didn't see what it was. Okay, not too fast, bro, because
awesome.
I can't wind very fast. Yeah, I'm getting a line back, so just. Yeah, this is good, bro. This is good. This is better than good.
Yeah. Good, mate. Oh, look at this. Here we go. We've got something on the line out there. Can't see it. No idea what it is, but good work,
and
mate.
The coolest
this is
thing.
The best.
Well, so far this morning we've seen wahoo, yellowfin tuna, and mahi-mahi. So three of the coolest fish in the universe, and I've hooked one of the three. I've still got about, I don't know how much, because I don't really use this gear. I know it's heating my hand up anyway.
Oh, get it in here.
Uh-oh. Listen to that line go. Oh,
big.
No! Oh, we're having to chase this fish. We're having to chase this fish now because I'm getting low on line. It stayed up on the surface, eh? Which is not like a tuna, eh? What's that? Might be a mahi-mahi, yeah, but hasn't jumped, eh? Mate, it's still got heaps of grunt, whatever it is. A wahoo probably would have bitten the fly off unless we've just hooked it right on the lip. Oh, this is awesome. This is ruling my world at the moment.
Yes!
Uh-oh. Listen to that line go. Holy smokes.
Oh, what have I got here?
Ooh. That's a beauty. Okay. Watch out for the teeth. Oh, my God, you just smashed it. Oh, yeah! Oh, this is awesome. This is ruling my world at the moment.
Yes!
Oh, mate, you know, like, you don't have to catch a huge marlin to get a real big game buzz. You just, you know, mix up your tackle. Mix it up, people. No, don't go to that old snapper hole your old daddy taught you about and put your burly bomb out. Well, you can do that,
Don't mix it up, man. This rules.
On a fly rod.
It's a little Shimano fly reel and a G Loomis fly rod. And all the fly fishermen that see me are quite envious of my fly rod. I've got to say, it does feel quite nice. Well, there's my fly line. I think when this fish sees the boat, though, it's going to have plenty more left in it. Ah, oh, getting some real stubborn resistance now. This fish is digging down deep. And I don't want to apply too much pressure because I've only got a 30-pound leader. Okay, the fish isn't too far away now. Here we go. What have we got? What have we got? Mahi-mahi!
Ahoo!
Mahi-mahi on fly. Look at it just cruising out there on the surface.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Come on, Matt. Yee-hoo!
Oh, yeah, this is good. This is good. I've got a feeling he's not done yet. Oh, beautiful fish. Oh, Blair's going to be getting the gravy shots. It's going to be gravy.
Oh, yes.
Okay, we're getting it close now. It's just digging down. Of course, this fly rod doesn't offer much resistance. Okay, here we go. Here comes my leader. I mean, it's only 30-pound, bro. This is your chance to shine, Ali. Remember, the money from this fish is going to buy our first round of beers tonight. Go right in there for it.
Yes,
it's the bull. It's the bull mahi-mahi that ate the fly. Look at that.
How's it in there?
Oh, awesome. Yeah,
oh,
right in the corner of the mouth.
Gosh.
That is so rocking it. Oh, mean. Right, do you want to whip off a couple of stills?
Yeah.
Because I may likely never do this again. Right, I better do a shout out to Craig Worthington, who made and gave me this fly. Cheers, Craig.
This mahi-mahi is easily the greatest fish I've ever caught on my fly rod. And in the conditions, it was a heck of a challenge and a huge thrill. But now I've got a tougher challenge inside the coral reef. Fly casting to bonefish, giant trevally, and a whole range of tough tropical fish that reside in the beautiful Aitutaki Lagoon.
Today, we're going to be spending the entire day fishing in the beautiful surrounds here of Aitutaki Lagoon. We're going to be right up in the shallows. We're going to be doing all sorts. Joe's going to be doing all the presenting. And Joe, you could probably start off by finding out from our guide, Ian, here, exactly what we're going to be doing, because I just want to get my gear rigged up and get fishing.
Mate. Right, Ian, what's the plan for today?
Going to have a quick look for some bonefish.
Choice.
Then we're going to have a look for some GTs.
I've been after those.
There's been some nice GTs up on the flats and they've been feeding on the bonefish. So
I think Matt's pretty keen to get out there and
Okay, right. Let's get amongst it. I'm so empty about this, it's not funny.
We get two different types of bonefish as well. We get the round jaw and the sharp jaw.
Anyone will do, mate.
Keep your eye on the edge, Matt. The GTs will cruise along the edge.
GT?
They'll just be right along the edge.
Oh, you just said two of my favourite letters of the alphabet at the moment. G and T, the giant and trevally.
Perfect bonefish condition.
Oh, yeah, look at this. You'd see one now, wouldn't you?
This is right in front of you, mate.
What's that?
Right in front of the boat.
A fish?
Big cast.
Oh, yeah, it is a big cast, especially for me, mate.
That'll do, that'll do.
Let that sink?
Yep. Big fish out here, look at him. See, straight out. Big G, mate. You see him? He's coming straight towards us. Here he is, coming straight towards us, look.
We're in the stunning tropical island paradise of Aitutaki. And I've brought along the equally stunning Joe Holly to help me present the show, so I can maximise my fishing time chasing a whole variety of fish on offer here, inside the lagoon, and out beyond the reef in the open ocean.
Oh, you got a bite?
Yeah.
This is Joe's first time presenting a fishing show, and she's loving it.
Mahi mahi on the line. I'm gonna fillet this fish.
And she's showing us that she's quite capable of mixing it up with the boys.
Just make sure I...
I'm also having a go at something unfamiliar, fly fishing. And while it's a bit tricky, I've got to say it's a heck of a thrill to tangle with a tough fighting fish like a mahi-mahi on fly fishing gear.
Yeah! Boy! Go right in there for it.
Yes!
It's the bull. It's the bull mahi-mahi that ate the fly.
I see now why so many people are into fly fishing. But mahi-mahi aren't the big attraction here. Fly fishers the world over travel to the Cook Islands to fish the shallows right here inside the beautiful Aitutaki Lagoon.
Big fish out here, look at him. See, straight out. Big G, mate. You see him? He's coming straight towards us.
Yeah, stick. Do you want me to flick that?
Go now. Where is he? I've lost him. Here he is, coming straight towards us. Look.
Yeah. Oh, he's still coming at us. He's still coming at us. I might be able to intercept him with this lure. What's he doing?
Oh, he's looking.
Oh, he had a look. He's right here. Right here. Oh, look, he's just...
Mate, that's...
Oh, has he seen it?
You see him and they're following all the way to here. They tend not to eat.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
it's normally in the first couple of cranks, they go bang. They're following all the way. They tend not to eat it all the time, you know.
Yeah. No, he didn't even look at it. I went right past him.
He's not interested.
No good.
No good. Let's move. We might just head down the 1 foot for a wade now while we've got a bit of sun.
Oh, yeah. Goes over there already, eh?
So we've just come across some guys out here fishing and they've hooked up on a bone. So I've shot across. Matt's still out there still trying to get his one, but we've got one here and I want to see what these guys look like. Woohoo! There you go. Choice, eh?
Slip in here now and have a wade, have a look for some bones in the shallows.
Okay, so we're just going to park up on here and walk it?
Yep.
Oh, wicked. Wicked!
That's what bone fishing's all about, mate. None of this boat stuff.
Look at this, it's a postcard. But we're not a travel show, we've got to catch a fish.
Yeah, that's right. Yep, big fish, mate.
Seen one?
Yeah. Big stonker of a thing, mate.
A bone?
Yep. Straight out in front, mate. Nice and long, about 11 o'clock. As far as you can. Go there. Come back with the breeze. Oh, he's just come through here and dropped off the edge. Another good fish. Mate, let's head back along that ridge.
Back where we come?
Yeah.
Now, that right there is the very reason that the trevallies and everything are right up in the shallows. These guys are almost trying to bottom themselves out so the trevally that are cruising the edge of the sandbank here can't get to them. And that is why we're fishing here.
See?
How far away?
He's going
up. Oh, yeah, I see him. Yeah, I see him. I see him. It's a long cast.
Long cast. Maybe the soft plastic's the way to go on that one.
Okay, you want me to go with plastic?
Give it a go. Go nice out, nice and long.
Out here. There's something out in the mix.
Let it sink all the way to the bottom.
Yeah.
Another fish right in front of you.
I see him right here.
Three quarters of the way to the edge.
I see him, yeah, I see him.
That's a bone?
Yep. And I'm just letting this rubble along the sand, am I?
Yep.
I reckon that...
There's two fish there, mate. There's another one coming in.
There's one after it.
Yep.
There's one after it. Just come on, eat it. There's two of them there.
Yep.
I could get to that one with the fly. He's turned around. Nah, he's spooked. What? You got something on?
Trev, yeah.
A Trev, oh yeah?
Little Trev. Come on down this way. Keep winding and wind fast. Get those arms pumping. No.
Look at this guy here. Look at this guy here. Just rod tip now nice and low and give it some side strain. Ow! What sort of Trev's that?
It's a little baby GT.
Baby GT? Wicked. We'll just beach him up on here nicely. Wicked. Well, there you go, you got your GT. Ow!
Mate, that is not the GT I want. I want bigger, more massive.
See, now all this talking we've been doing, talking it up, the old GTs, well, there you go. That's what they're all made out to be. These tackle-smashing brutes of the reef. Okay. Look, we've got to start somewhere, eh?
This would be some nice snorkeling up and through here.
Yeah, it's great in here, I love it.
Man, this coral is so razor sharp. She's on this lighter tackle. I'll cast. I'll worry about what to do if I do hook one, eh?
Alright, just keep your rod tip high.
What's your biggest GT?
60 kilo.
Oh, the donk.
Up here, right in here.
Right in here?
Yep.
So you've seen a 60 kilo GT in here and I'm fishing with this?
You back yourself?
Oh yeah, mate. Always back myself, bro. Hang on, I had a shot. There's a fish right here on my lure, following my lure.
Yep.
Oh, come on, eat it.
That was a big fish too. That was a big G.
GT?
Yep. Good fish.
Looks like Joe's got a casting down now.
Oh, here we go, MacGyver styles. Dun 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 dun. No luck over here. I wonder what old Crocodile Dundee's up to.
Yep.
Oh, he's on it. There's two on it. Eat him. Nah, they've pulled off it now. Oh, we've tried changing lures, line weights, techniques, or maybe it's colour. So we'll go the red. He's on it. Oh, eat him! Oh, he lost pressure. This is just awesome. That gutter there, got one living up there. Oh, mate, that got smashed as soon as it landed.
Did it?
Yeah, bro. As soon as it landed, it got smashed.
Big fish country in here too, mate. Ah, here we go.
Got them on? Good work. Holy smokes, they go. What is it?
Trevally, I think.
A Trevally. It ate that fly. And that's like a heavy 12 weight fly rod, is it?
Yeah.
You're going to need every bit of that in here, aren't you? To smoke that fly. See, now that's exactly why I'm not using a fly rod in here. Look at this. Oh, look at that line whipping out. Oh, you just let me know if I can help you in any way at all. You don't want me to maneuver the boat or anything?
No. Beautiful fish, bluefin. Beautiful fish, look at his colours.
Oh, mean. Trevelyan. Oh, beautiful.
It's foul hooked, I think.
Foul hooked?
Yeah.
Oh, that'll be why you're getting such a stubborn resistance out of him. Bluefin trevally, stunning fish. Yeah, how about you just look at Okay, 5 pound. Okay, we won't muck around too long. There you go, he's powered away. Beautiful, well done. Ow! All right, we've got a fish. That means we can use this cool footage.
The Aitutaki Lagoon is one of the most beautiful places I've ever fished. But right now, the fish just aren't on the tube. So we've decided to head outside of the reef to see what we can find trolling in the blue water. And once we're done out here, Captain Jason has promised a return to the lagoon for what he says will be a giant trevally encounter I will never forget.
Rightio, now we're trolling and who knows what's going to jump on.
Which one's going to go first? This one? This is what I want to happen. Bang here, bang there, bang there. That's on. All go.
And they're all yours.
Yep, we're on.
Pick the rod up. Go, Joe, we're going to clear these other lures. I don't think there's anything huge.
The real heavy enough.
I know, you're going to have enough.
I'm trying to bring it up.
You're skull dragging it, whatever it is.
It sounds pretty light.
Might be swimming towards us.
Jeez.
I don't think there's anything huge. Whatever it is, it could be good for a bait for us. Oh, it's a little wahoo.
Oh, yes.
Oh, it's a little wahoo. Me. Bring it this way. Bring it this way to me. Yeah, to me. Okay, I've got a gaff here, so see if I can do both. That got him. Hey! Oh, mate, that's a beautiful little wahoo. And I tell you what, I've got to just keep my hands clear of those mouths. Now, be very careful.
Yeah.
Because those teeth are like razor blades. They are unbelievably sharp. And it's a good thing that it was a bit of hard lure. You can see it's just nicked that leader there. You're lucky. See, if its teeth got anywhere near it. Now, that's only a little guy. In fact, at that size, would be a great dead bait for a black marlin. But here, I can see these guys looking at me as I'm talking about using a wahoo for bait, mate. There could be trouble because they taste fantastic. It's our sashimi tonight, eh?
Yum.
Sashimi,
nice.
Mate. I'm like, well done.
Thank you.
The provider.
What
easier on these rods, eh? Well, it could just be that you've got the superior technique. You dominated it. No, I mean, that's a small version. We get a big one of those, they can burn some line.
Nice one. Ow. Get it in the bin.
That's why we're trying to get the photos here. Just keep holding it like that, because this is a real graphic illustration of a real unique adaptation of the wahoo. You'll notice here that its top jaw is hinging up. All other fish have a fixed top jaw, and the bottom jaw comes up and down, snappers everything. Whereas these guys, I'm going to be real careful near these teeth. Look at that. The top hinges, the bottom hinges, and as it closes, those rows of teeth slide past each other like scissor blades. They don't crush, they slice their prey.
Boom. Ouch.
And yeah, keep your finger away from that one. Ew. Hey, they got them on over here. Looks like our support boat, camera boat, is doing a little bit more than filming. They're hooked up. Marara over there, covering the action. Renegade, runaway fishing show.
What do you reckon it is?
It could be a GT, it's pulling.
Yes. Here we go.
Yes.
Let's slow us down a bit, please, Jason. We're on.
Get in the gimbal.
Crank it in, because if it is the reef fish, it will go to ground. So keep the fish moving, okay?
Okay.
If it's running out line, that's fine, but no stalemates.
I love that sound. Strike. Fish is on. It's still on me.
Making
an
easy air
for this. Guns, eh? It's the guns. It's hard. Oh, there it goes, out the back. It's sucking him
out. Yeah, it's right on the surface. It might be a mahi or something. Broke the surface, whatever it was. Present, Joe, present!
Oh, mate, I'm just too into it.
Tell us what's going on. Holy smokes.
Oh, what have I got here?
It's a big barracuda. It's a great barracuda.
If I can...
Great barracuda. It's a big puppy, too. That is what you call a cuda. Holy smokes, that's a big cuda.
Oh,
it's a big angry one. And you can eat them over here, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, watch out for the teeth.
Watch out
for the teeth. And watch those hooks coming out too. Okay, we're just going to give him a bit of the welcome aboard bat before he comes aboard. Just watch out for these teeth as it thrashes around.
Hey.
That's a beauty. Look at those teeth. Now, I'm not quite so bold to be careful to open that mouth up because those teeth are like razor blades if it was to shake its head.
Crikey.
How's that for some dentistry? You look at those teeth, they're just like little individual blades. Slice up their prey. Well done.
And one that you can eat.
Yeah, boom. Yeah, that's a good distinction there that Joe makes. These tropical ones here are good eating. Yeah?
Yeah, really nice. Yeah.
What's the best way to have these?
Just lightly done on the barbecue and oil.
Oh, beauty.
Right.
Yodi.
To hold that one up.
Yep. Okay, yeah. Heads or tails?
Tails.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, there you go.
Go near that
for a pick. You gotta get a pick of that. That is awesome. Get a shot of those choppers there.
Not a marlin, damn it, but big and good. Big and good.
Oh, it's brilliant. It's brilliant.
We'll be eating this barracuda tonight with the locals. And our mates on the camera boat are still battling a fish that they want to bring along for dinner too.
Oh, look at it, so it is an icy.
Here it is, here
it comes. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah!
Well, I think right now we might just pop back inside the lagoon and have a real up close look at a giant trevally. Waiting for Trevor to turn up. Yeah. And we get to see how big and bad these things are up close.
When they scatter, the big ones are around. Big trevally.
Oh, they're off. He's here. He's here.
Here he is.
Here he is.
Here he comes. See that big dark shape down there? He's heading straight towards Blair. Oh, he's a donkey. He's a donk. Look at him. He's a donk. Oh! Oh, oh, he's there. Oh, he's in there. Look at him. Go! Oh. That is the coolest thing I've seen all day. Look, he's right there. Oh, look at him. Imagine trying to stop that. That was sick. Well, we couldn't manage to entice a bite from a giant trevally, but we found a giant trevally. We've just burled up here in the shallows, and we've come to get some footage just to see what these awesome things are like up close. Now, this one's a resident guy known as Trev. And he's quite some trip. Ha, 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 look at him! Here he is! Whoa! That is sick! Look, he owns this. He owns this reef. Now, here we go. Oh, he smokes! He just smashed it! I feel kind of a little bit clumsy here because I've got fins on. So I thought I was going to have to dive to get him to come up. But this guy's got absolutely no fear of me whatsoever. Oh, this is awesome. Oh mate, this is better than throwing poppers. This is way better than throwing poppers. Like I've always said, jeez, it was close to my hand. I've always said, fishing for me is all about the bite. And getting to see awesome predators up close attacking their prey, well, holy smokes, the way that's smashing through the backbone of this bit of yellowfin tuna. This guy's responded to the burly and he's just charging around here, fired up. Okay, fingers. Okay, you can have it, bro. That's all yours, buddy.
Matt's having all the fun out there, so I'm going in as well.
What a treat to be able to spend time in the water getting up close with one of these formidable shallow water predators. This guy is around 40 kilograms, and you can see why catching one around a sharp coral is such a challenge. And just as quickly as he appeared, Trevor's had his fill, and he slides back away into the deep. And it's also time for us to head off. But rest assured, we've got another great fishing adventure coming your way soon on Ultimate Fishing.
If you've enjoyed this episode of Ultimate Fishing with Matt Watson, chances are you're going to want to see some more. Well, we've got you covered at ultimatefishing.tv, where we've got fishing action filmed from all around the world. Big boats, small boats, all kinds of tackle and fish, advertising free. It's all covered at ultimatefishing.tv, or you can download the free Ultimate Fishing app.